Hi, so welcome to this short video. In this video, I will be explaining how you could register for the top 100 coders event, which is an event that is being conducted by GTech MuLearn in collaboration with the Kerala Startup Mission and Huddle Global to find out the top 100 coders of the nation. So for registering this event, first step you have to do is to visit our official website, and from there you could see a register link over here, and on clicking that you will be directed to the Huddle Global website, where you will be presented with the form in which you have to fill in all your personal details such as name, email address, etc. So this is the email that you will be using throughout the event, and enter your mobile number as well so that in case of any communication we can contact you. So alongside that, you need to also enter in your GitHub profile, since this is a coding event, that's a mandatory thing. So github.com, here I am entering my profile, and on clicking the submit I will be redirected to a page that has the steps that I have to follow in order to participate in this event. So for the first step, they are asking me to visit a GitHub repository, fork the repository, and follow the instructions which are given in the readme to set up my profile. So that is the step that has been said over here. I will be receiving the same as a mail also, so do check that out as well in case you miss out on this page. So once I get to the GitHub repository, as you can see over here, the steps are mentioned in a more detailed manner over here, and the first step is to onboard the GTech MuLearn Discord server. And if in case you have any doubts onboarding the server, you could actually view any of these videos to onboard the server. Once you have onboarded the server successfully, you will be given a MuID, which is a unique ID, just like the UPI ID for each of the users, and that will be a unique identifier for identifying you just as the email throughout this event. So once you have actually gained your MuID, you could continue with the step 3 onward. So in case you are in case you are new over here and you haven't onboarded the GTech MuLearn website or server yet, you could actually view any of these videos according to your language preference and onboard the server. So coming to step 3, the first step that I have to do is fork this repository, and inside the folder name profile I need to create a file that starts with my MuID, and it should be a markdown file. And I need to, using the template.md, I need to create a similar file and fill in that. And once I have completed doing so, I need to create a pull request to this repository. So let's see how that can be done. So the first step would be to fork this repository. I guess I have already forked the same, since I have already done this. Let me show you that. So for forking this, you will be having to click this button, and once you do so, you will reach a page immediately. Let me quickly reload it. Yeah, so if you haven't forked it, this option will be already there for you. Since I have already forked this repository, it's not present for me, and you could create a fork. And once that has been done, a clone of a copy of this repository will be present in your GitHub account. So let me go to my GitHub account and check out that repository. One second. Yeah, so this is the copy of the same repository that exists in my account. So this is my account, and this is the official GTech MuLearn's repository. So once that fork has been done, you will get a repository similar to the one in the GTech MuLearn in under your account. So the forking procedure has been done, and over here the next step is to create a folder, create a file inside the slash profile folder. As you can see, here is the folder, and you could actually clone the clone this repository and do it either in I prefer doing it locally, but that is more easier. So inside the profile folder, you could actually create a file which starts with your MuID, which can be gained after onboarding the GTech MuLearn Discord server. Once that file has been created using the template.md file that has been given over to you over here, you could copy this and edit it over here. So just like Alan K. Anil has updated the template with this things, which is data, you could actually create a file that starts with your MuID, and by copying your this template file, you could create the same. And once that has been done, this is done in your local, in your forked repository, and once committing that, the next step will be to create a pull request to the main repository. And for doing that, once you have pushed the commit to this repository, this green button over here will be active, and by clicking this you could actually open a pull request to the main repository. And once you have opened the pull request, that will be visible over here. Let me see over here. Yeah. So there, as you can see, there are almost 11 active pull requests, and our moderators will be reviewing this, and any update that has been to be done will be mentioned by them in the discussion section. So just like here, Vishak has mentioned some request that this is an invalid request, just like that. So you can make the changes and open a pull request. Once the pull request has been successfully merged, you could actually share this link in the Discord server as a task and gain the karma points. So once this has been done, you could actually see, once after the pull request has been successfully merged, you could see your file alongside this other files in the profile folder at the GTech MuLearn repository. So once your pull request has been made, if you open this repository and go to the profile file, you could see your file also being listed here. So once that has been done, the next step would be to go to our Discord server and share this file of the merged file in our Discord repository. I will show that as well. So once your pull request has been merged, you could find your file name from the profile folder, copy this link from the URL tab, and inside the Discord server, you could see a top 100 introduction, and over there you could actually share your link alongside a small introduction that describes basic details about yourself. So once that has been done, our moderators will flag and award you karma points just like this if everything is all right. So once you gain karma points, you will be listed in the leaderboard, and as you can see over here, there are almost 100 plus participants already participating, and by completing the task, there are n number of tasks already listed in the announcements channel. By completing one by one of these tasks, you can gain karma points, and by gaining karma points, you could become a person in the leaderboard. So just like this, if you could come to the top, Arfas has already gained over 7000 karma points by posting various tasks under the top 100 coders event, and he is top on the leaderboard. And just similarly, there are other people with lesser karma points on their way to reach the top first. So that's a short introduction. This is only explanation about the first task. As I had already mentioned, there are other tasks also for completion. So I hope you complete that as well. So once, in case you have any doubts, you could join us for the top 100 office hour, which is being conducted in a regular manner every day at 8 PM. And our moderators or someone from the support team will be there to help you out in case you are facing any issues regarding the task submission or registration. So see you over there. Thank you for joining in, guys.